told her, we actually want you to win, so if you, we didn't need to win, but we said, we want you to win, but if you are getting beat in the last 50, you're free. She won very frustrated. So it's legal to do that, and it's kind of fun to do that if you're that good. By the way, you only get that good, Elizabeth knows, critical velocity, you only get that good at the other events if you train them the same way you train freestyle. So we believe that, I believe, that the swimmer of the future, we'll talk about backstroke a little bit today too, the swimmer of the future will be a lot more specialized. And right now you're seeing a lot of people swim a lot of different events, and they're doing well, or they're winning a lot of different events. I think that's going to go away. In the future, there'll be a sprint freestyler. You never find somebody like Katie Ledecky in track, ever, in history really, unless you go back, I don't know, you have to go to the Stone Age or something. Somebody that can run from here to that door and win is a completely different person than the person that runs a marathon or even a 10K or whatever, 5K. But in Katie is showing us that we're not training right, and she is, bottom line. Bottom line, she's doing it better in almost every way. So we're gonna learn from her, and that's why you're seeing so much of her. But Michael Phelps taught us the same thing. He was doing it right, and we were doing it wrong.
Do you feel like there is a better way to perform freestyle than traditionally?
Yeah, I think there's always a better way. I do. In fact, that freestyle used to be, you know, trudge and crawl, where you had to bend that knee. Some of you are kicking like that now. Michael, I saw you earlier, a little bit big kid still. Where the leg kind of goes sideways and stuff. They actually used to teach people to do that, and that's how they raced. And somebody figured out how to do a small, fast kick, and it changed. I think one of the things people are experimenting with is dolphin kick during the arm stroke instead of flutter kick. And people experiment with it. It's very hard to time it, but I have a feeling someone is going to do that very, very well, and then you'll find, you know, other people will try to do it well too. Dolphin kick during the freestyle stroke instead of flutter kick. Okay, so I think there's going to
be
somebody.
Legal?
Yep, perfectly legal. That's what we call it. It's not really freestyle. Freestyle means just about anything, right? It's really American crawl that we do. And there's difference. We'll show you some different types of stroke within American crawl. Different breathing, different stroke patterns. Different. Are you talking over me again? Go over to that side, please, behind her. Thank you. Do you do this in class?
No.
How are your grades?
She was telling me that, what about that, all the strokes you can do in the.
So you got her and you're in trouble. Don't get him or him in trouble. Okay, come over here. This better for you, right? We're just trying to get you to focus. Okay, yeah. You only have him for short time.
Right here?
Right behind her.
My question is which is more better, like if you wanted to get a fast time? Is it circle swimming a better way, or is it just going back and forth?
What's the shortest distance between two points?
That's what
it is.
Circle swimming?
Tell me what's the shortest distance between two points?
You only have to go one.
What's the shortest distance between two points? If I want to get from here to my camera, what's the shortest distance?
Just going forward.
Straight line.
Yeah.
That's what it's called in the physics, straight line. Straight line. If I go here and then here, I went farther. Do you agree?
Yeah.
So what's the answer to your question?
It's actually going straight.
Right, Elizabeth was just saying she's wandering in backstroke. She's the wandering backstroker. And so she just did that this weekend and dropped her freestyle times and thinks she didn't drop her back because she's wandering. Okay, that's definitely possible. You can swim a long way with long course and long course pool because the lanes are usually wider. And so she could go kind of, you know, I mean, I could be here and then here as I go to my camera, right? And here and then here. And by the time you're just in a straight line and you're going to be. It doesn't always work that way, by the way. You can make mistakes in your stroke and still win races. Is that true?
Yeah.
Okay, so that is not the marker. You do not rate yourself against other people to find out what's best for you. Understand? Now, you can rate yourself against other people to find out whether you got on the victory platform. It's not a problem. I don't have a problem with that. But the reality is, if you want to get as good as you're going to be, you have to rate yourself as compared to what you think you can meet the principles we're talking about here compared to you. Okay? Does that make sense? Even the younger people? That makes sense? So you're comparing against you, and this is the greatest thing about swimming. In water polo, a lot of things can happen. In basketball, same thing. Yesterday, I mean, really, the team that lost played an amazing game, but the team that won played a better game. That doesn't happen. It does happen in swimming when you rate yourself as to who took first, second, third. I agree with that. But as far as who's going to stop you from dropping time, no one. You know, that's the great thing about our sport, and that's a good thing. Yes, question.
So would it be if you were doing freestyle in an event, would instead of doing freestyle kick, would you be able to do any different kicks instead of freestyle?
Yeah, you sure could. No.
Because it's called freestyle.
That's right. You're allowed to do any kick. Actually, you're allowed to do any stroke, as I said. We have breaststroke, breaststroke, and breaststroke and stuff. So, let me see if I can get this computer going on just a second, and I'll get to your question. Okay, good. Yes?
When you said Janet, when you were with Janet Evans at a swim meet, was it long course or short course? Cause
well, she was best at long course. She was short. She was pretty short.
Because at Janet Evans, there's like this part of short course and then a part of long course.
That's right. And I still remember coaching where that T is, and a stinking train would go by, and I'd try to yell to my swimmers at that T. Yeah, you know? So she who else is from Fullerton? Are you the only one?
Yeah.
Fullerton Aquatics. Yeah, if you who's been to FAST, the Fullerton Aquatic? Anybody going to do a meet there? Nobody else? Okay, yeah, there's an L, and so there's a diving tank and an L, and I'd be standing at the L trying to coach, and the train would go by, and I'm just like, wow, and I'm screaming and yelling. But I like that pool. That's the DMV, which I'm never going through and spending too much time. Yep.
What Michelle was saying about, like, different strokes or different tricks about freestyle, would you be able to do that in, like, an environment?
You can do it in any meet, but would you? And that's the question, is when you start to choose to be creative, this is not art.
Again. People are in the restrooms, I don't want to go by themselves.
Yeah. Oh, you haven't gone, okay, go ahead. Yep, thank you for taking it. Sorry, you're going to miss a little bit. We are on video, listen. All right, so, yeah, you have to decide, okay, that's very creative, and it's really fun, and it's a stroke, let's say some of the stroke drills we'll show you, and some of the stroke drills you do at your team. They're really fun, they're really great. Unfortunately, sometimes people are better at stroke drills than they are at swimming. So, you know, you can have a great stroke drill, but you really like it, and your coach is really creative and everything. I know some of the least creative coaches in the world were some of the best. I know a coach that every stinking Monday, they did exactly the same thing as every other stinking Monday. But the good thing about that is, you know if you've improved, right? Whereas if you got somebody like me that's really creative, and now we're doing freestyle with a dolphin kick, and now we're doing wall push-ups, and now we're doing this and that, sometimes it's hard for even me to tell whether or not the swimmer's improving, but at least it keeps them happy and keeps them, you know, motivated and stuff like that. But yeah, his point was, and he said this in a book, and one time I heard him say it in writing, and he didn't say it in the nicest way. You'll actually see this coach on Butterfly Day. But he said, I'm not here for your, I'll say stinking. I'm not here for your stinking amusement. I'm here because you said you want to swim fast. Bottom line. You want to swim fast every Monday, same thing. And let's drop it. And he expected a drop every Monday. And if you didn't, you paid the price the rest of the week. So everyone was really motivated and nervous to swim that set. It was like 21s or something like that. And every single Monday, you would do that 21s. And every Tuesday, you do the same thing as every Tuesday. And every Wednesday, you did the same thing as every Wednesday. It's boring? I agree. But again, do you want to be the fastest in the world, or do you want to be the fastest you can be, or do you want to be entertained? There's a lot of good movies out there you can be entertained by. So, but I'm a very entertaining coach, I think. We do a lot of creative, crazy things. I use tons of technology, and I encourage coaches that are with me to use technology too. But there's a point where the technology can be more important than the person, and I think the person is the most important thing. So you have to figure out this out. Okay? If you were on my team and you didn't film yourself tomorrow at practice, you're going to be on my team. I wouldn't coach a team that's like that anymore. That's why I don't coach full time. Yep.
So if you do the same thing every Monday and every Tuesday, wouldn't it not be boring? You'd be just getting better at it every day?
It depends on you, doesn't it? Right? The coach can say some 2 hours of freestyle. You can, or 10 minutes of freestyle. And you can decide to think about the things we're talking about and these things, or you can just be lame and just can put one hand in front of the other and wish you were gone. Wish you were doing something else, right? So that's my favorite. So one of my books that I wrote is there's two swimmers, you've heard this story. There's two swimmers swimming, they're exactly the same in a kicking set, let's say. They got kickboards, they're ready to start a kick set. One of them's exactly the same though. Same height, same strength, same best times, everything is exactly the same. But one of them's thinking, man, this is great. Last time I did this, I averaged 130 on these 100 kicks, 100 flutter kicks. I averaged 130, I'm gonna try to go 129. The other one is thinking, I hate kicking. I hate it, I can't wait till I get out of it. And especially flutter, you know, I'm a butterflyer. I don't want to swim flutter kick, right? You've been both of those swimmers, haven't you? I can see it in your faces, right? So one's thinking one thing, the other thing's the other thing. At the end of the set, maybe if it's a movie story on that very set, the one who's thinking positively won. Maybe not, too, but probably. But at the end of 2 months of thinking that way, these people are going to look completely different, aren't they? The one that was going 130 is not going to be 122s or something. The one that was one, the other one that was 130 is probably going to be about 130, maybe 133. I mean, they hate it, so why should they put anything into it? And it hurts, you agree? All out flutter kick, 100 flutter kick, hurts, right? So the people come to me and go, how come we don't use fins more? Because on my team, they don't ask for that. You know why? Because when you use fins on my team, I expect you to go faster than you can swim. So if your best time is 110 in the 100 flutter, 100 backstroke, and you get fins on, and you're just doing fins, first of all, I expect a spin turn, not a cheating flip turn or whatever. A spin turn, I expect you to go faster than 110 with fins on. You think that might burn a little? It burns a lot. Now, some people like that. They like to burn. If you like to burn, you're going to be fast. You gotta love the pain in our sport to be good, right? Probably in any sport, right? Just like if you want to be really good as an architect, you gotta love studying like crazy. Sitting in that little cubicle and drawing those lines on that table and all that, you gotta love it, right? Or if you're gonna be an astronaut, you know, you gotta love being spun around in a circle and your eyes bulging out, right? You gotta love that stuff, throwing up and people taking blood from you all the time. That's what they go through all that. You guys have seen movies about astronauts. You gotta love what you do. Well, I love this. So when I go home tonight, I'm gonna think about better ways and read about better ways and watch videos of better ways and talk to great coaches like Coach Rick and other people about better ways to be able to get this message through to you. I'm talking about, or I'll talk to my friends that are scientists about what is it? When do we rest them? Do we rest them every Tuesday, right, or every Wednesday morning? Or do we just go right on through? Michael Phelps didn't miss a workout for 5 years. How in the world can you motivate somebody to do that? Well, I face-to-face asked Bob Bowman that, especially with a swimmer that was a sort of attention deficit. Didn't miss a workout for 5 years. Got kicked out of workout a bunch of times, but didn't miss a workout, right? Showed up every day. How do you get somebody who's that good to keep trying that hard? I'm interested in stuff like that. Are you? I hope so, because we're going to see some psychology videos here today, too. But should we get the heat down a little bit? So let's start to get down. Maybe it's me talking so fast.
It's
question.
So funny. Every time you, get in the pool and start swimming, eventually you start gaining endurance and speed.
Maybe. Right? Why did I say maybe?
Because it's not.
Why could you not get better, right? I mean, when you ask that question,